Hello there, geographers, and welcome back to the Mr. Sin channel. Today we are going to look at 8 different land use patterns that you need to know. As always, if you find value in this video, consider subscribing. When talking about land use, we are looking at how people have modified the natural environment to create a built environment. The built environment refers to human-made or constructed surroundings in which people live, work, and interact. Essentially, it is the physical infrastructure, buildings, spaces, and systems that are created by people. Now, land use patterns refer specifically to the spatial arrangement and distribution of various human activities and functions on the Earth's surface. We can see that different land use patterns can be observed across different regions and places, with each land use pattern giving us a unique perspective about life in the area. Residential land use consists of areas primarily designated for housing. These areas can include single-family homes, apartment complexes, townhouses, and other residential structures. Oftentimes, these areas vary between low-density suburban neighborhoods to high-density urban areas. Depending on the density and the types of homes in the area, we can gain different insight into the cultures that may live there and the life that most people will likely have. For instance, lower-density areas often rely more on personal vehicles to get between different places, while densely populated urban areas are more likely to rely on public transportation and have smaller homes. Commercial land use involves areas designated for business and commercial activities. This can include shopping centers, office buildings, restaurants, hotels, and other commercial businesses. Generally, we can see transportation hubs and major roads connected to these areas to help facilitate the movement of goods and people in and out of the area. Areas with more economic development tend to have more commercial areas due to having their economy have more jobs located in the tertiary sector instead of the primary and secondary sector. Speaking of transportation hubs, we can also look at transportation and infrastructure land use, which comprises of areas occupied by transportation networks, including roads, highways, railways, airports, and seaports. These areas are vital for the functioning of society and help facilitate the movement of people, goods, and services throughout the entire society. Geographic areas that lack quality infrastructure risk unequal distribution of resources, which may be due to a lack of economic development, corruption, or poor urban planning. The next land use pattern we can observe is industrial land use patterns, which are generally associated with areas where manufacturing, production, and other industrial activities take place. These areas may include factories, warehouses, industrial parks, or specialized industrial zones. Industrial land use patterns are typically found away from residential and commercial land use patterns, as they have higher rates of pollution and lower land values. Areas that have emerging economies with more jobs located in the secondary sector of the economy tend to have more industrial areas due to many of the jobs in the economy being located in manufacturing. On the opposite side of the spectrum, we have agricultural land use patterns, which consists of areas that are used for farming, cultivation, and agricultural production, often being made up of crop fields, livestock farms, and agricultural infrastructure. These regions will vary depending on factors such as climate, soil conditions, and the different agricultural practices in the region. Generally, regions with less economic development will have a higher percentage of their workforce located in agriculture. This also tends to impact demographic data as well. For instance, societies with an agrarian-based economy tend to have large family sizes compared to economies that are more economically developed. Shifting away from agriculture, we can also look at institutional land use patterns, which are generally made up of areas that have been designated for public facilities, such as schools, hospitals, government buildings, libraries, or community centers. These areas provide valuable services for the community and can increase the land value and general well-being in a region. Another land use that is designated for the broader community is open space and recreation land use, which includes areas set aside for green spaces, nature reserves, sports facilities, and other recreational amenities. These areas provide different leisure and outdoor activities for residents of an area and allow for people to relax and have fun. One other land use you may come across is mixed use, which are areas that combine multiple types of land use together in one single development or neighborhood. Oftentimes, this includes a mixture of residential, commercial, and recreational areas. These land use patterns are typically found in more densely populated areas or urban areas, with the goal being to reduce the amount of travel time and increase the walkability and accessibility in a region. All these different land use patterns modify the Earth's surface in different ways to provide different goods and services for society. Different cultural, economic, political, and geographic factors all play a role in shaping these land use patterns, with each land use pattern revealing different aspects of a society. For instance, societies that have more traditional gender roles with less economic development and have less political representation for all people will often have more land dedicated towards agricultural production, have higher birth rates, which could put pressure on settlements to provide enough housing, possibly leading to informal settlements to form, and may see less land designated for institutional land use, since more people work on their family farms, and women may have less opportunities for education. So the question now is, how is land designated where you live, and what does that say about your home? Remember, if you found value in this video, consider subscribing. And if you do need any more help with your AP Human Geography class, don't forget to check out my ultimate review packet. As always, I'm Mr. Sin, and I'll see you next time online.